Hello?
Hello?
Yeah, are you there?
Are you coming today?
Justin. Yeah, why do you have to say Mok Malaka Ben Koka in
more community? Ben Koka, it's Mayaka, no?
Yaka, I mean, you can take a Kantono Mario.
Yeah?
Yes, it is a Kakuma American, okay?
It is a Mangala, Kavo Mendae.
Mok Malaka Ben Koka, all right? Kabe Ben Koka, passe, you know, Labi, moi, il est chamou, qu'elle est née, bon, à la manu, Goranga, ou ta, Franca, Locacia, et so. All right, if we speak from Malamola for a few times, so you can have a body casting, but if you can look for it, come in for, okay? Thank you very much for being here, you know, and I apologize because I went off because somebody interrupted the conversation, and so we're going to call, and sometimes if they call you direct, you know, you lost the connection. So that's what happened to me exactly. So what we are looking for here today is the peace, all right? What we are advocating for is peace. If you have any contribution to share with us, let you know. So we don't want to tell you guys who to vote for. We don't want to preach politics here. I'm not here to talk about politics. I'm here to see how best our youth in the community can be, you know, patient. You know, they can hold their peace and stop, you know, those kinds of tricky words, all right? You know, throwing words to the others, because in case of any violence making, all right, it will be a problem on our leaders, all right? More especially in Washington, so we don't want those stuff to happen, whether it's a true level to him, all right? So, Liberians, vote the rightful person. A good position that you think, yes, indeed, they can intervene peace here. All right, I think my brother here trying to come in. I'm gonna call him so that he can come on and tell us what exactly he's thinking about peace in our areas. All right, I'm gonna off the music, the entertainment stuff right here. Good morning, sir.
Yeah, good morning.
Yeah, your from name my, and where you're calling from, sir?
To be precise, I'm Adam Sangari. I'm calling from Newark, United States.
All right, you are live. People are listening to you. What do you have to say? What do you have? Which are the messages do you have to pass to the Liberian people to entertain peace, to love peace, and to pray for peace in the nation?
Oh, well, that's a good topic, and I think that topic shows all Liberians need to come out and put hands together and have a nation as one people with one common goal, because you look at Liberia as a country today, you know, Liberia being the oldest country of African continent, and yet the peace have not been preserved in that country. And I think this is a time Liberians should come together to unify that country with one voice, all right? Liberians have a thing and need to have a flashback, in the sense that Liberians have war in that country. And I think this is a time Liberians should have a reflection there. Actually, we as a Liberian have had war in that country, in the war which brought nothing like, but rather destruction within the country. And I think this is a time Liberians should come together and how well they can move that country forward. All right. The Liberians should understand from 1990 to present, they were not able to bring any change in that country. All right. If you look at the youth of that country, their life has been handicapped. All right. Where you see people have politicians, everybody trying to discuss politics. All right. You see youth are not even advocating themselves to how well they will change Liberia. All right. I think this is the time Liberians should come together to unify that country. All right. And they should try to forget about too much of politics. And you find a country that where the education system is very poor. All right.
Very, very poor.
And the country, I remember, if my mind can set me, I think Liberia, there was a time where the state university, I mean, people went for the entrance, all the students failed, nobody passed in the entrance. I mean, these are the things that people should look at. And that's the country, you say, that's my country, educational level. All right, whatever that you think in terms of development, everything, infrastructure, everything is done. If you look at Liberian Civil War, the war that happened in that country, and the war was actually classified as dual frame, all right. Everything was, pulling out and just saw everything, right? You could see people themselves, those who were fighting, you could see them taking the gun and just even putting a label down the poles and all this stuff, right? So these are the things that Liberians should think throughout. And yet, this is the time we Liberians should come together and how well we're going to unify that country, all right? And we are calling on you, like, I appreciate you. This money for bringing that topic around peace, all right? If we have a peace in that country, Liberia will move forward, all right? Because Liberia, if you look at Liberia, Liberia is not just a small country, and Liberia have set so many records, but yet there's no development in that country. I feel sorry sometimes, and I feel ashamed, because I won't call that sorry, but I feel ashamed when I see the image of Liberia. Especially when you're out of the country, you see some things that are, like the bad image of that country, all right? I mean, African, all right? Liberians remember the time they said, time finished, all right? At that time finished. And this time around, we as a Liberian will make sure we come as one voice and be able to have chosen good leader for our country, a leader who will have a love for the country, a country that he or she will make better, life condition for the people, and Liberia will be a better place for Liberians. Because if you look at Liberia, I can tell you for sure, Mr. Moderator, nobody going to leave their perspective country to go to Liberia and go make Liberia a better place. Liberia has been classified as a garden, as a farm, all right? The colonial fathers, the colonial masters, up to present, they still call in that country a farm. I can tell you for sure, look at Liberia. Liberia have a largest wall of rubber plantation. Liberia, the one rubber tree during the war was more valuable than human life. Could you imagine? The rubber tree, just one rubber tree, all right, was more value than human being in Liberia. Liberians, you understand that, yeah, they are human, all right? Like, as irrespective of the other people, they are human like other countries, you know? They have to come together. If they fail to come together, I think they will still be regretting. I think labyrinth, this is the time labyrinth should forget about the tribalism, nepotism, segregation, all right, and accusing one another, all right, and stigmatization by other tribes, calling each other by name. Labyrinth has a unique tribe, specific tribe, a 16 tribes. All right, I think this is the time they should come together. And I mean, this united division that is just among themselves, they should forget about that and how well they can move their country forward. I think Labyrinth should understand right now this is the time for peace. And also Labyrinth should understand the peace they have had for the past 12 years. They understand that the level of development Labyrinth were able to do within that particular time, that 12 year. If you look into Labyrinth today, you see the image of Labyrinth have changed a little while. All right, where you see the infrastructure and the roads and other things, you see life and left have changed. All right, Labyrinth were on the street, but today Labyrinth should be continuous stuff, and Labyrinth should come together and for the past 12 years. Yes, we want that peace to be continued, my brother. I think that's my contribution.
All right, thank you very much. But one question here: Do you think in building nation, updating things in a nation, making sure that Liberia, because we all believe that we deserve electricity, we all believe that we deserve a good road network, we all believe that we deserve our country to be updated. Everything should be updated. And, do you think that those developments that we really, really need, that we're really, really looking for, do you think that those developments can come with our peace?
Oh, okay. I understand. If I can understand your question, you talk about how can you have a development within a country when there's no peace. And I can tell you, move forward, all right, if you don't have a peace, all right, in that country. And let me just give you a scenario. From 1990 and to 1997, you understand that there was nothing done in Liberia, to be precise, because there was a war in Liberia. There was a fire, all right? There was a fire in Liberia, all right? The civil crisis in Liberia. You imagine when people are fighting, there's a conflict. The first thing you need to do is to make sure that you want to protect your life. All right. And you're going to see people running from left and right. So nobody going to have a mind for development. And those that are in charge of leadership, this is something to invest a lot of money, invest the public fund. All right, so there won't be no development. So if you want to preserve peace in the country, you want to preserve the development within the country, the first thing you have to unify the country. The people have to come together as one people, all right, with one common goal. If that happens, then you're going to have a development. All right, for instance, right now, can you go and have a farm that you want to harvest, all right, a rice farm or whatever farm that you want to do? When there's a heavy rain is falling, when there's a heavy rain falling, you will not do it. The rain has to see you before you start, all right, cutting the grass and making it play well, better place for your crops to grow good, all right. Now, when you have a war in Liberia, and when you have a disunity division in Liberia, will you have a peace? No. And I can tell you for sure, you cannot have a peace in Liberia if the minority rights have not been given to them. We have a people in Liberia, they are citizens, but they have not classified. They have not been, they found them that they are citizens. They only need them whenever they want them for political means or for different things. But, and after that, for a period of time, they start calling them, they are aliens, all right? Then Liberians start calling each other, among the 16 tribes, and that 16 tribes calling each other, yeah, you are aliens. No, I think Liberians have to embrace that 16 tribes. Probably they should pray for addition. So I can tell you for sure. And a few years from now, the Fulani will be counted as one of they are already citizens, because the Fulani is that right now. I can tell you, Mohammed, those that are getting the LeBron passport more than everybody right now is the Fulham community. The Fulham are getting a lot of passport, and because they are sitting there, when they come up in the team, look at LeBron.
All right, Adam.
Spending 30.
Hello, are you here?
Are you hearing me?
Yeah, Adam.
Yeah.
Can you give me three reasons, right? Can you give me three reasons why we need to do or why we can do, because we realize that all the 15 tribes sometimes go against, all the 15 tribes go against one tribe, which is Mandingo tribe, right? Can you tell me three reasons, right? That yes, indeed, we need to put in place in order to put stuff to those kinds of things in Liberia?
The reason are very, very simple. You know what I'm saying? You have a national government, all right? I think the national government
because
has to realize.
Because said that those people, you know, they can only need Mandingo people if they want to use them, like in terms of voting or any other stuff. But actually, they don't actually count them. You know, like
now,
Liberian, they always count them as alien to the nation, right?
Yeah, to be precise, Mohammed, it's not only Mandingo, to be precise, you know what I'm saying? And I say minority. The minority right has to be given to them, all right? They should understand that, yes, we are.
And who are those minority that you think that, yes, indeed, they are not treated fairly in Liberia?
Yeah, and sometimes the minority, Mandingo is not only the minority. And sometimes, let me just put it in that way. Let me just say Muslim, because if you go by the way in a Muslim in Liberia, Mandingo is not only Muslim. You have a vibe, you have a gola, you have a gay, you have a kiss, you have all tribes there. They are Muslim, all right? And the people right have not been given to them. And you know what I'm saying? For instance, you as a Liberian, and if you look at people always say Liberia was very Christian principle. You know that's a false. And Liberia is not that country that Liberia was very Christian principle. Liberia is a secular state. All right. When you have a country that is secular state, Mohammed, I think everyone has a right, their legitimate right, their constitutional right to exercise their right. Right. And the right of practice of religion and whatever, what the right of practice of your culture, your social norm, all right. I think the people, this is the time the national government should understand that. Yes, I have a children, all right. When we have a government, every citizen, will have children of the government. The government should realize that. Yes, I have a children and I have something to share. I should have authority to share equally, all right. But you cannot prefer some group and forget about other group. If that happens, you are bringing chaos, all right? For instance, if you look at the community, probably they may go with the other people, yet they still have that bad feeling in there, yet the government did not recognize our right. All right. I think this is the time, if the government tried to do this thing and recognizing the right, and let government look at the constitution and respect the constitution. And every Liberian have to respect the constitution, Mohammed. And sometimes, I'll always this, right? Liberians should understand this is not just a government. Liberians should understand is the people make the government, all right? It's people make the, if you define the government, all right? For the people and by the people, right? Government is there for the people and by the people. If that happens, Liberians themselves have to come together, make government. They have to decide, yet. Men and women.
All right, Samuka Kone, if you are listening to me right now, you are asking for the topic. The topic here today is peace. Do you think anything can be done within a country without peace? So what we are seeking for here, what we are preaching here is peace. What is your contribution towards Liberian peace? All right, or Africa as a whole? So that is the peace we are talking about here today, if you are listening to me. All right.
Yeah, that's what I'm saying. Yeah, back to what I'm saying, Mohammed. This is time Liberians should understand. Yet, indeed, we Liberians, we need peace. All right. Let Liberians look at the other countries, especially the countries that have fought for war. Like, let's look at the Arab Spring. Since, like Libya and the rest of the country in the Arabian Peninsula, what happened up to the present? There's no peace. Look at Syria. All right. The people are flowing daily basis. Up to present, the people are not able to preserve peace. Liberia should understand, should realize. the time that the Liberian civil crisis were ongoing, and for the part two from 2006 to present, they should take their own mind. They should do the analysis to compare that the lie of that two terms, right? All right, they will understand that for the past 12 years of Madame Selele's administration, I mean, level of peace and stability Liberia have had in that country. I think this is the time Liberia should understand that we as a Liberian, we don't want war anymore. So we, Liberia, will make sure we preserve peace in this country. And every man and woman, right, will be given to them. I think when that happens, Mohammed, Liberia will go forward.
All right, thank you very much. At least you share us your view, and I think this is the audience are listening to you right now. You make a very good point, and they themselves are enjoying your points, and I believe that they're gonna actually, you know, choose of what you have said. You know, they're gonna choose their own, because if people makes a comments, you know, they are making those comments for you to listen and also accept it. So not only listening, but you need to accept the fact. So while we are talking about him today is a peace.
And Mohammed, let me tell you this thing today, Mohammed. You know, sometimes we as a, I can say analyst, right? Sometimes when not just analyst, but sometimes we see and analyze yourself, then you have become a good person. I'm urging all Liberians, right, especially the youth make this 65% Liberian population. They should understand that Liberia is the only country they have, all right? And those who were opportune to go out during the Liberian civil crisis, I mean, their will of understanding, and those that were born in the country up to present, they are still there, Mohammed, is very different. So I'm urging national government to please, I'm begging the national government to please provide scholarships for Liberian children to go out, all right? As Mohammed, all right. When they are opportunity to go out, when they go and see the other countries and getting that higher education, come back to the country, I think they'll have a developmental mind that yes, we Liberian will not go into war. Mohammed, Liberian youth are very quick to be fooled.
Very smart. The entire world says this.
And you understand? Mohammed, Liberian youth are very, they are people that Mohammed, They are quick to be convinced, all right? Mohammed, even when you go right now and stand, all right, just take my microphone and start saying anything, Mohammed. Liberian, they will believe you. They're quick to believe things. And that depends because majority of people, they're ignorant.
Oh, yeah,
and
we are good at that, believing with us saying.
Believing things are that, it's not even factual, Mohammed. And that's what we are trying here. I'm telling the national.
Lives, we don't make riches, nothing. We just believe.
Yeah, to please allow the Liberian children to go out for study, Mohammed. When that happened, then, and I believe that will bring a lot of changes in Liberian community, all right? And I'm urging Liberian, those that are in the diaspora, can they come together and make sure seek scholarship. Mohammed, look at Nigeria, Mohammed. If you look at Nigeria, Nigerians that live out, they lobby, things are right from the various NGOs and the rest of the other things to make sure it goes back to their country. But yet, Liberian, those that are working, the government and the rest of the other people that will call in the hierarchy within the country, Mohammed, they want to take everything out of the country. They may take things to censorship out. Mohammed, how can that country be like that? You think that country will be built? Mohammed, imagine, look at something like Liberia. All right. Those who have a business, Liberia, I believe, I honestly, everybody know that Liberia don't have their own business. And you know, the business, the Liberia economy have not been controlled by the Liberia themselves, but rather the Liberia economy is controlled by the foreigners, the Lebanese and Indian. Mohammed, can you point out any specific, like a good infrastructure that those people they are undertaking? The people come within the country, Mohammed, and just come and build stores. Their war horses all Iran. All right. Mommy, imagine, look at from Freeport. From Freeport to Madua. So, Mohammed. Go to Relay again. So. I hope you get what I'm saying, Mohammed.
I'm listening to you. And the audience too are listening to you.
That kind of country we have. From Freeport to Madua Market, Vatan area, Claritan area, Mohammed. Just look at it. The city view of that place. So store, Mohammed. So store. We don't have anything to point out. All right. Can you point out Reina Mame besides Cinco in Liberia, that in the capital city? In a league world contest, there's no player that you can boast of. Nowhere. You go, when they call Banga, when you go to Banga, you feel discouraged. When you go, anyway, Reina, Ganta have a pressure a little bit. All right? And I prefer Ganta Reina a little bit because the Nimbanians, they are trying. We really commend that they are trying. All right. And Mohammed, how can you have a peace within a country when you have a land dispute? That's what I said when the minority rights have not been given to them. You have a people in Liberia, they are minority, their rights have been seized, right? You know, you have some Mandingo, some tribe, their land has been seized up to present, government failed to problem. That's why we are telling you, Mohammed, I cannot have a development within a country when there's no peace. The people are grieved, right? There are so many people that are grieved. Understand? Mommy, you understand Liberian civil war, for instance, those who lost their loved one, all right? And now, losing your parent or losing your loved one is not a problem. But the little much the people left for you to live your life with that. And somebody should come and just see that. Like, those who have a land, their land have been incarcerated by these people up to present. They have not been given their land. Mommy, can you tell me, will you have a development within a country where there's no peace, when the people are not satisfied?
It's very, so very hard.
People are grieved. Now, that's what we are calling the national government. The national government should stand. Yet they are government. All right, they have a responsibility. They should understand responsibilities. When they understand their responsibilities and their function, I think Liberia will go forward.
Yeah. All right. Thank you very much. I'm going to connect you later on. I think that you have a millions of comments that, yes, indeed, you can talk to your people in order to, you know, love the peace that the way you do. And because we all believe that without peace, we cannot take even a step. All right. So, brothers and sisters, today topics is based on peace. If you are saying anything here, please try to say something about peace. All right. Peace is the one that we are looking for. Peace is the one that we are advocating for. All right. Thank you very much, Brother Adam, and I'm going to connect you later on. Yeah. All right. A lot of people trying to call here, but... morning.
Yeah, good morning. Good morning. How are you?
Yeah, are you there? What is your name and where you calling from, sir?
Oh, I'm Lucini Asata Abukaba, and I'm connecting you from Monrovia, Liberia.
All right. Welcome to the show.
Thank you.
All right.
No, I just coming on. So can you just brief me?
All right. So we are talking about peace here. All right. So today's topic is based on peace. All right. What do you think? Because we all believe that nothing like development can be, you know, in place without peace in a country. So anything you're doing, peace is the source of everything. All right. So now, before we talk about development or before we talk about political, you know, aspiring or whatever, all we need to do first, we need to convince people, we need to talk to people, you know, so that they can love peace, so that they can apply peace through all their life, so things can be, you know, things can be in order. Because without peace, we believe that, you know, everything will go wrongly in the country. So now, that is why we are talking about peace. So if you have any comment, because I believe that you're just joining us. So.
Yeah. All right. Thank you. Thank you very much.
Yeah.
Yeah. Thank you very much for connecting me. But what I would like to tell the audience, in order for us to pursue or maintain our peace in Liberia, it's just about one thing.
All right. Hello. And what is the one thing?
It's just about one thing, because we cannot just continue to talk about peace, 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 if we don't take time to rectify our mistake. And that mistake is what? Hello?
I'm listening to you, and the audience are listening to you too. Go ahead, hello? You are live. Yeah, you are live.
Yeah.
You are live. People are listening to you.
Yeah, okay. As I was saying, in order for us to maintain our peace and stability, is about just one thing. And that one thing, the peace cannot be maintained without that. That is why the people who are ahead of us, the people who we consider to be our leader, the people who we consider to be our, you know, the people who is in our forefront, they are not very fair to us. And if those people are not fair to us, then definitely this peace will not continue. Because these people are the same people that are going around castigating messages to their people and to the lover of their party, you know, to do what they want. And the first thing, in order for us to maintain this peace, the National Election Commission have to be fair to everybody, because you cannot just continue to tell somebody that you are making mistakes. 3 times since the election process has started, and they have come out to tell everybody that they have been making mistake. What a mistake is for?
Mistake by calling giving the wrong figure to the audience, or
Figure to the nation. Because every time when they come out, they're giving the same mistake. Even if you are not a mathematician, you take your calculator and do your own set calculation, you will see that the same message he gave you again is the wrong, is the wrong message. It's not a tool.
I'm not actually cutting you off. I just want to make this point clear. All right, for that side, we know Liberia, our electoral process, everything is done by hand. All right, everything is done by hand, and it's from people to people, people to people, up to the head. All right, so this is why sometimes they make a mistake, and we realize that we all are human beings. All right, so making mistake, it doesn't matter. If somebody make mistake and they realize the mistake that they did, and then they come back in public, because I can remember, they make a mistake by calling the wrong figure to people, and then they come back again and say, I call a wrong number, and my daughter, you know, was the one who briefed me, and I'm here to rectify the mistake. So those people, we all believe that, you know, we all are human beings, and we can make mistake anytime. And in our communities, more especially Liberia, you can do the best of your ability. Stay, people can criticize you. We all know that. All right?
Yeah, of course, of course, of course, of course. Hello.
Actually, not do anything.
Yeah, but the one where you are telling me that making mistake to rectify the mistake is not a wrong thing. It's a very big wrong thing, because, you know, rectifying your mistake against somebody is a very wrong thing, because what the man is doing. But the little man in the corner would not take it into consideration. He or she will feel that, you know, you are stepping on his right, or you are marginalizing him. If I can recall, George Weah of CDC was ahead of Joseph Baker about 47.something%. But why now the point has dropped to 39.6%? Why? You can't continue to do this mistake. You can't continue to do the mistake. If you are doing it continuously, we will tell you that yes, you are cheating the people. Even though I'm not a supporter of CDC, but in order to pursue this thing, in order to pursue and maintain this peace, it's up to this election commission. Because what they're going to give us is what the people are going back. And the situation are all around making a lot of remarks hello?
Yeah, we are listening. Everybody is listening.
Yeah.
Everybody are listening.
The seditions are passing around making a lot of remarks. So in order for people to be, you know, convinced, in order for people to know, you know, you have to do your calculation before coming out to the audience. But you can't just, you know, get up in the morning and then go in the afternoon and give wrong information to the people and come back again and tell people that, no, this was the wrong figure I gave you. This is the right one. Even if the right one the man giving you, you do your self calculation, you will notice that yes, that calculation was very wrong. And you see, eh? So if you know that yes, you know, everybody know that you are looking for certain point in order for it to not be second round, or you know, in order for it to just remain, But in order to do so, just be fair to the other person. You know, two brothers can be in the same house, they're making confusion whole day, then you are just, you know, picking on the other person, telling the person that, yeah, you are not right, you are not right. Then forgetting to know that, yes, what the other brothers are doing to the other brothers, you know, you are not getting into the nature of the case. Then you just go against one person and tell him, you are wrong.
If I can understand what you said,
yeah, we need justice, you know, we need fairness.
That's the one thing that you can really, you know, comment on. That's the one thing you're talking about, justice.
No,
right?
It's not the only thing. I have a lot of issues to be discussed, because actually I was listening to the program live yesterday, but in order to come on, it was very difficult for me because I was having network problems.
All right. I'm sorry about that. So what else that you think that yes indeed we need to put in place, or we need to talk to our people so that they can do and we maintain a peace in the country?
Okay. Having said that, hello.
Yeah, you are making very good point, but
having said that. Besides the justice, we have other things to maintain this peace. What is that? We have to know where we are coming from, and we have to know who we are addressing. Because you can't just go out and then address somebody any kind of way you are afraid of. Hello?
Yeah, we are listening to you. Everybody here are listening to you.
All right. Thank you. That is, you know, we have 16 tribes in Liberia, and everybody knows that. Then why is it that everybody is just going against only one person? Wow.
So what is that one person? What is that one person?
My brother, you are in the U.S. and I think you were living in Liberia. You know the struggle you passed through, and you know when you get interested to go intern to go process your document, or when you get in bus to go process your document. You know the circumstances that you used to pass through. So, in order for us to just continue to, you can't just continue to. Emphasize only one side. You all know that Majingo people have been marginalized massively in this country, with no doubt. And oh my god, somebody just disturbing my line, man.
Somebody interrupted, and your voice go down. And I think right now the audience are not hearing you clear. I think so.
Yeah, I said that. You getting me?
Yeah, I'm getting you, but I guess that if the audience are listening to you, I don't think so.
Yeah.
I don't think that they are getting you.
Okay. That one person who everybody is against is the Majingo people.
All right. So what I'm gonna do here, because you are making a very interesting point right now, and I believe that people would like to listen to what you are saying. So I would like you to disconnect and try to connect you by, because you are sounding very low, and people who want to listen to you or who want to get your view may not actually listen to you. I mean, may not actually hear you clearly. So I would like to disconnect you and then connect you by. All right. All right, that was Luseni Asata Abukaba from Liberia. So he was trying to make a very important point here that yes, indeed, things that we need to do to grow. All right, he's back again. All right, you are live, sir.
Hello.
Yeah.
Okay. You getting me?
Yeah, we are here.
Okay. And that one person is known to be Mandingo in Liberia, as I was saying. You know, right. Everybody is just against this one trap. Even if we do the right thing, we do the wrong thing, they will say, you know, that they are way of doing things. That's a simple way of saying it. So if you talking about this particular piece, this piece will not go nowhere if these people are marginalized. Because I will not let for my brother to suffer right in my eye, then I look at it and go free. In order for me to satisfy myself is to save that brother in your hand. So there's no way I can stand somewhere, somebody going against my brother, calling me Martingo Door, calling me fully asked from Guinea, this, that. Even though, you know, I have a background coming from Guinea, coming from Mali, or from different places, that one would not make me to harm myself from you. Everybody,
that's not even important, you can come from elsewhere. Once you are born to any nation, directly you are the citizen of that place.
Yeah, so everybody here have a background. Everybody here have a background, and everybody know they all came from somewhere before they could become a Liberian.
Yeah. The basso, the crown, everybody from everywhere, the love of liberty brought us in Liberia. But the question is, are we entertaining this? All right, we say one love, you know, for all Liberians, but I don't think that this is entertaining Liberia, because it's somehow to say, all right. So go ahead, brother.
So that's the issue that I'm trying to emphasize on. If you really want to encourage our Liberian brothers and sisters on this program, you know, you have to, you know, send your messages through all to your friends so that everybody can just share it. So this program is very much important to, especially the way that living in Liberia, because we know the kind of situation we are undergoing. We know the kind of situation we are, you know, we can encounter to everyday activity. If we continue to be like that, then definitely the peace that you are talking about will not be maintained.
All right, you know, sometimes we can tell people that yes, indeed, this program is very important. You need to share this program, but sometimes when they left, they cannot share it, and you can't hold them responsible. Why you do? Here, we're going to really ask you to participate by sharing this video, you yourself. And again, we're going to ask you to make your hard contribution by giving us three important reasons that you know we can do or we need to talk to people about, so that this one trap that has been marginalized, you know, people can recognize them, people can know them, people can love them as Liberian.
Yeah, when you ask me that, you know, I would like to tell you the three things, because one issue here, we the Mandingo people, we have already been trying our best in order to see how best this peace can be maintained. Because for one far, hello?
Yes, we are listening to you.
Yeah, because for one fact, as you already know, that one of the great scholars just leaving from Liberia, who happened to be Sheikh Ahmed Awa, and the man came here to preach on a topic called peace and reconciliation. And I think, you know, I can say almost 75% of Liberians, you know, They really embrace the idea and they really admire the man, because this is a man who really open to the book, to our noble book, which is Quran and what, Holy Bible. And you get it? So the man made everybody to understand what the Islam, what Islam means, to what Islam means to society, and the man also preach on what we should know how to treat our neighbor. And you get it? So I think every majority of all embrace the idea and will really admire the man a lot. And secondly, I think you know that Sheikh Khalid Yassir just arrived today. Sheikh Khalid Yassir again, another scholar again, from another Islamic scholar again. So they're all here just for the same reason, to come and discuss on the same topic, peace and stability. And you get it? Because if you don't know the importance of peace, the people that have been hustling around, the people that have been struggling around, the people that have been, they put our open to the society, they know the importance, because we Liberians know where we are come from. Because I was speaking to you right now, I'm one of the victims of Liberian civil war. If you see today that I've not gone nowhere into my education, that is the same reason that I've not gone nowhere.
The Civil War contributed to your education, right?
Yes, it has great effect on me. Not only on my education, but it destroyed my whole family affair. It destroyed my whole family affair, because some of my great parents were dead. I need to see. I never lay eye on them. In order to know my history, there was no opportunity for that.
And we are sorry for that.
Yeah, there was no opportunity for that. I went in a refugee camp, Kiankola, and spent about 4 good years before returning back to Liberia. So I know the importance of peace, and I know the importance of, and I know the impact of war. So as he already in the know that Khalid Yassir is already entered, and he's going to preach on the same topic probably by Sunday. And it's going to be at our second big fee, to ATS.
All right, ATS.
So maybe we'll be carrying a program live for everybody to listen to him also.
Mr. Kaba.
Yeah.
So what is your message to the people of Liberia regarding the marginalization that they are carrying on against one tribe? So what do you have to tell them? All right.
Okay, what I have to tell my brothers and sisters tonight is that let us know that we are brothers and sisters, and we have been neighbor. We have been neighbor together, and we have been living together since in the 80s, because it is only God who can really decide to be, for someone to be a particular tribe. So nobody pay for it. Even I was speaking to you, my grandfather or my grandmother did not pay to be a Mandingo. But it is the destinator who decide that, yes, we are going to be this tribe. So, hello?
Yeah, we are listening to you. You are live.
Okay. Okay, thank you very much. It is the destinator who decide for a particular person to be a wa Padingo, or a particular to be a Wagyu. So nobody love it for it, and nobody pay for it to say, oh, I want to be so tribe, because I know the kind of enjoyment the people can go through. No, nobody pay for it. One person will never tell you, say, they pay to be a Madingo. No, even if you pay for it, you must know that, yeah, you are not it. You are not a Mandingo. So, in order for us to live in harmony, in order for us to continue our peace, in order for us to really be brothers and sisters, because we must know that we hold each other responsibility. If you don't know that we hold each other responsibility, you will get to know that when war comes, and you're getting a God forbid, nobody is praying for what?
Yeah, Mr. Kaba.
Yeah.
Let me quickly read the people's comments to what you are saying. Somebody said that you are making a very interesting point here. And this somebody said also, great Mr. Kaba. And somebody said that, brother, really, there is nothing but the truth. So I think what you are saying, people really, really admire of what you are saying. I really like, this was great. All right. So I'm going to have you back again. The three things that, yes, indeed, you think, three important things that you think, you know, we need to talk about so that the people of Liberia, you know, can do in order to recognize Mandingo tribe in Liberia as Liberian, like they themselves, you know, I know. They have to, because most of them, Mandingos, are Liberian, and they are in the tribes that is listed in the country. But yes, indeed, Mandingo is always called aliens. I don't know why. You know, even me in person, something like that happens to me. But in order to advocate for peace, you need to forget about the past, because in this civil wars, if you realize some people, you know, they lost their mother, dad, father, everything. They lost everything, all right? If they keep thinking about what has passed already in the past, actually, they can, if you preach peace to them, you know, they will feel like you are speaking nonsense, all right? Because of if they think what happened in the past, all right? But, brother, you know, things happen to everybody. If war comes in a country or if things are wrong in a country, everybody will feel it. Right? Whether you are Mr. SYZ or SY trap, you will feel it. All right? Poor will feel it, rich man will feel it, smart man will feel it, dumb man will feel it, everybody will feel it. All right? Even down to the animals of the country, everyone, all living beings in a country will feel the war. All right, this is why we are trying to talk to people. We believe and we understand that, yes, indeed, there is nothing called enjoyment in a country. Without peace, there is nothing called development. Without peace, there is nothing called, you know, we are going to build the good road network or anything you may think of. And, you know, peace is the source of every development, all right? This is why we cannot stop of talking about peace, preaching peace to our people, all right? And I believe that you make a very interesting point here, and people like of what you have said. And, all right, Adam sent a comment, so I'm going to have you later on so that you can give us the three main reasons. All right, that's the only point really I really need from you. All right, I'm going to connect you later on so that you can give us your three points. Your three points that, yes, indeed, we need to talk about.
But why you can't just give me an opportunity to elaborate on the three points you are talking about? Because I'm so interested to this topic to the extent that I have, you know, I really want for my voice to be heard.
It's like we want everybody to contribute. We want you to give us 3 points of your choice that, yes, indeed, you think if we talk about this to the Liberian people, yes, indeed, we can recognize the one thing that, I mean, the one trap that have been marginalized in the country, all right? This is why we are asking every one of us, because we know one man, one idea, two men, two ideas, all right? Group of people.
Yeah, but it's not only about what I like, but it's just going to be a suggestion where everybody will be listening to me, so that, you know, because it's a just piece of advice. Because if we don't disseminate this information, it will really affect us tomorrow. Because
somebody sent a comment. I don't know who sent this comment. This is a very important comment that I really, really love to the bottom of my heart, and that is the Mama Ture. He said, one love for all Liberians. Oh, this is very, very interesting. All right.
Yeah, so
and that's what one love for all Liberians.
Yeah,
should I give
the 3 points you are talking about or you are
all right. If you have the 3 points or if you can think and then I'll connect you back, you know, if we can think over the 3 points, because those points that you are giving us, we are really writing down, and so that we want to gather more points from people, more views from people, like supporting views, we're going to be writing it down, and then anytime we are talking about peace, and then we're going to quote that, oh, Mr. XYZ said, in order to maintain the peace, we need to do so, we need to avoid this, you know? That's why we are asking every individual that are participating in this show today to give us 3 main points, you know, 3 main views that yes, indeed, we can talk to our people, we can talk to the people of Liberia so that things can be like the way we expect it, you know, in order to restore peace.
All right, thank you very much for the opportunity.
You are live. Are you there? Goes away. And Brother Adam Sangare said that you can't have no development when there is no peace. Brother, absolutely 100% truth. Nothing you can do in the country, right? Nothing you can do for your people more than peace. All right? Nothing you can do for your people more than peace. All right? It's the source of all development. It's the source of all updating aspect in a country. It's the source of everything that you may think of in the country. All right? And then he said, when the majority right has not been given to them. Oh, if the majority right has not been given to them, and then the national government has to know their functions, all right? So if the people of Liberia, the governments of Liberia, if you are listening to me right now, yeah, Brother Sangare said, Adam Sangare, that you guys to do your functions, all right? You need to know your functions. You need to know your functions, all right? Make sure you equalize all Liberians, all right? That's the only way Liberians can be one, all right? We can say, Liberia, we need to come one, but how, the question is, how can we be one, all right? How can we be one, all right? And then Adam make a good, very important point here. He said that the only way is that the government should know their functions, all right? And knowing your function is nothing else. It's about the justice. Everybody should be treated equally, all right? Those that are, you know, abusing one trap over and over, I don't think this is the solution to our development. I don't think this is the solution of peace, all right? If you love peace and if you know what peace is for, or if the peace is important for you, we all see the 12 years peace we went through, and you know how enjoyable it was, all right? So if you know what I know, you need to stop those kinds of statements to the others, all right? Let love one another, and you know, let try to love one another, let try to do something that will actually, and you know, restore the peace in among us or in our nations, all right? Because those kinds of words or those kinds of statements to the others, it brings something in minds of people, all right? It calls people tension. And once people are in tension, sometimes they cannot listen, all right? So brothers and sisters, if you are listening to me today, let us join together. Let us give hands together so that we can talk to the people of Liberia and, you know, to make a peace, all right? And this peace cannot be making without the people of Liberia. You are Liberian, you need a peace, and you need to advocate for the peace, all right? And Adam said that we are responsible to build Liberia. No one else is coming from elsewhere to build Liberia. But I have intention of building a nation, or you have the intention of building a nation, but another person is there telling me that, all right, you from elsewhere. Even I have important development to carry on in a country like that, and, you know, I will feel like, you know, I'm not treated fairly, all right? Somebody from elsewhere is telling me that, or somebody from the same country is telling me that, oh, you are not from here. In fact, you are now a Liberian. What really in Liberia? What do you think that is in Liberia that, yes, indeed, people have to leave their different nationality and come to force themselves to be Liberian? What do you have in Liberia? That's the question. What do you have in Liberia that, yes, indeed, people are going to leave their important nationality and can't be Liberian if they are now Liberian? So if you see anybody, you know, telling you that, or anybody has a Liberian passport, are telling you, oh, I am a Liberian, I don't think you are the rightful person to tell the person, say, you are now a Liberian. Is you who born him? All right? You are not the one who born him, all right? He know his nationality, he know his right, he know where he belong, or he or she belong, all right? So I don't think this is the rightful thing to do in a country, man, all right? So, like the way Lucky Dubi said, Lucky Dubi said that Liberia, we want to see you guys in peace, all right? We love to see you guys in peace, all right? And we'll always preach so that you guys can love one another, all right? So now you're going to listen to him for a little bit. What? All right, if you want to call to be part of the show, you can hit the green button and then you're going to be live. All right, excellent, December Bay. He said that so true, Adam. The leader are the problem for our nation. Oh my goodness. So leader, if you are listening to me right now, people are making comment about you. So you need to be straight, all right? So justice is what we want so that people can be united, man. Right. One love for all people. Hey, the people of Liberia. People of Liberia. Hey. One. Come together as one, the people of Liberia. That's what he's trying to say. People with different conduct, but we need you as one. Liberia. Together, they must come together as one. The love of liberty brought us here. People of Liberia, one. Be real together as one. All this beautiful music is for you in order to come together as one.
the beautiful music. People of Liberia, we gotta come together as one. Hey, people with different color, but yet still, we want to see you. Come together as one. All right, that's why Lucky Dubi said that the people of Liberia, we know you are people with different conduct, but yet still we want to see you, and we want you to come as one. All right, so those people are singing for you in order you can restore the peace in the nation. All right, don't be arrogant, don't be something that, yes, indeed, we don't even know. So you have to accept the fact. All right? You have to accept the fact. I'm going to try to connect this guy here. She's trying to come online, but she's not accepting the invitation of call. All right? Oh, so sad. All right, once again, if you want to call here, either you send okay, as a comment if you want to be, if you want to call to give us your point, or you hit the green button on the right hand side, and that's that little green button on the right hand side at the bottom. So you need to hit it, and then we're going to add you, all right, so you can make your point. All right, we need more comment. If you cannot actually call, because some people are not actually good at talking, if you cannot actually call, you can write your comments and then send it so that we can read to the audience, and so that they can know what actually you are trying to say to the people of Liberia. All right? So that's why we said that, Mr. Kaba said, I think that's a very important point that he makes, because in order to call for peace, things that is wrong, you need to know those stuff first before you call for peace. All right. So now somebody say that the government is one of the problem, and somebody said that government needs to know what, you know, their functions, all right? So they need to know what they are doing, you know, and they need to know their functions by, you know, by treating everybody fairly in the country, all right? The priority should be given to every one of us as Liberians, all right? Some people shouldn't be treated, you know, like the way they don't deserve, you know. Some people, everybody should be treated like the way they deserve, all right? Mr. Ansu Belete, trying to come online, all right? Let me try to add this brother online here. Ansu Belete, if you are listening to me, you can hit the little green button on the bottom side of the right so that you can be added, all right? That's the only way you can be added, all right? All right, people trying to come online. I'm sending invitation to them so that they can be live and tell you guys what exactly we need or some of those mechanisms we need to put in place, and, you know, in order to take away marginalization of one tribe in the nation of Liberia. All right. So, oh, he dropped the line. All right. Let me try to invite. Let me try to call people so they can give us their reason. They can give us their view. They can tell us actually what we need to do.
Trey, why you want me to go live? I'm driving, watching you.
Oh, my goodness. However, all right.
How you doing?
So, when you get, are you going to work or you are heading to the house?
Yeah, I'm going for interview, so.
Oh.
I said, let me go watch the guy. What did he get to say to the Liberian people? So.
Anyway. What we are talking about here today is peace. Anyway, since you are driving right now, I think we're going to drop your land down. Or if you have anything to tell people, if you don't mind, no problem.
No, another time. Right now, I'm on the highway, so another time.
All right. So now I'm going to have you off, and then we're going to see another time.
All right. Thank you.
Thank you. All right, we're gonna keep calling people here to get their views from them. All right, so Malcolm Goodwin, I sent you the call, and then you just need to accept the call, and then you're gonna see a blue body who say go live, and then it does a blue body, and then exactly, you're going to be on live and tell people what you think that, yes, indeed, those things that we need to put in place in order to maintain peace in Liberia. All right? Oh, my God. I really need to call you. Okay. I know you have a very important point to make in you have, all right. People send their, all right, decision here. All right. All right, somebody said that I should tell her what actually we are talking about here, because the person said that explain what decision is about for new, you know, viewer. All right. Actually, like we said, we are not here to preach politics. We are not here to tell people go out there, vote for Mr. XYZ or vote for Mr., you know, just like that. No, we are not here for that. What we are here for, I mean, the reason we are here for today is to, you know, tell the importance of peace to the people of Liberia, to make them understand that without peace, you know, nothing like development, nothing at all that we, yes, indeed, we're going to enjoy. And, you know, together, the only thing we can enjoy and the only thing that can bring development, the only thing that, yes, indeed, you can see country update, and, you know, updating is peace, all right? Peace have to be among us. We need to accept everyone as Liberian, all right? Once the person, you know,
is in a country with you for long, long period of time, why are you still denying him of being, you know, Liberian? So these are some of the stuff that, yes, indeed, we are discussing here. But actually, we are not discussing about politics. And one thing again, any candidate, all right, any candidate of people choice that they try to, you know, vote into the into power, that's the choice of everybody, all right? That is why we are talking about here, all right? Any candidate of people choice is my choice, all right? To be, to admit the fact, I was in support of ANC, but he did not go, and that's not my problem. My problem here is to welcome the right. I'm sorry, somebody interrupted. All right. So, all what we are saying here, Liberia first. No matter who you are, or we don't know what is your intention to the great country. Although the country is a very small country with a lot of comments, a lot of voice from people, you know, a lot of discouraging voice from people, you know. And let me tell you something. Let me tell you something, and this is the fact, whether you like it or not, this is the fact. A country cannot be built without strangers, all right? Because people coming from elsewhere, they come in with their talent, all right? So if you welcome them and you give them, you know, a freedom so that they can, you know, give you their talent. But talent is something that is in me. The only way I can share it with you is that if you love me, you, and then loving me is not a matter, but you show me that you love me, and then I show you my talent, and so that we can move forward, all right? But every day you telling me, say, I'm from elsewhere. Do you think even I have a good development for you? Do you think that... I'm going to be courage enough to carry on those developments, all right? I don't think that they're going to be possible, all right? Because the entire world, everybody, you love someone who loves you, all right? You love someone who loves you. You like to do something good for or good people who may love you good, all right? Sometimes you do things for your enemy, but that is done conditional, all right? So we don't want enemy shape here, and, you know, like the way we are praying for change. So if change comes, please, if change comes, if president are changed, I know it doesn't mean that Liberia changed. All right. Our major concern here is the people of Liberia. That's the question. Are they changed? They need to be changed in order for the country to change. But even the president has more things to do. They have more thing to do, all right? And they have more thing to say. But it left with the people of Liberia to accept them or not, all right? They can only say something, or they can only make decision, all right? For the decision to work out, it's not going to work out with all the people of Liberia. And again, I want to take this time to give my thanks and appreciation with my honor, right, to the security of, to the Liberian security. All right, who are trying to do their possible best to maintain the peace of Liberia, even though they are not actually, you know, taking that kinds of, you know, that much of pay, you know, but they are trying their best because they know that they are working for their nation. All right, so together, let us try to respect those or people, you know, those security police force, and the immigrations that really, and the other forces that really maintaining our peace in Liberia, all right? The armed forces of Liberia, our thanks and appreciation goes to you guys. Really, you are working hardly to work the Liberian unity, to work for our peace. And really, we appreciate of what you are doing for us at this wonderful time. And I know you're going to keep doing this. At all time, I know and I believe this, all right? So the only thing here, let us try to talk to people, you know, to stop making negative words to people, to some people in Liberia, all right? If you feel that you are a crown, crew, basso, or whatsoever, and then you think that another tribe like Madingo, that they are now Liberian, then you are lying to yourself, all right? And like that, we are not going to move forward. And like that, we are not going to go nowhere, all right? Because for one fact, the development that we all need today, oh, Liberia has gone 170 years, you know. In fact, we don't have water, we don't have current, we don't have, you know, and still the entire world is referring to war from the majority of population is living from hand to mouth, and is war, one of the world poorest country. All right. So I think if we don't entertain peace, all kinds of description that they gave us, we deserve it, all right? So we don't want to hear those kinds of words because it burned down our heart, all right? It burned down our heart, and actually, we want to talk to you guys to see how best we can change this, all right? And district number two, somebody tried to interrupt. I'm sorry. All right. People trying. Okay. And Smooth, that don't say that. All right. I mean, this discussion. Which discussion are you talking about? All right. So anyway, let me try to put you online so that you can tell us what exactly you mean. So you need to come online and I sent you the invitation. You need to accept it so that you can exactly tell us what you mean. All right. So you can give us your contribution towards the peace in Liberia. All right. So if you are there, I sent you the call. Just all you need to do is just accept it, and then the blue button that will appear say go live, and then you click. All right. Good afternoon, sister.
Hey, what's up?
Oh, cool. What is your name and where are you calling from?
I'm Masa. I'm calling from, well, right now I'm in Pennsylvania.
I'm sorry?
I say I'm Masa. I'm calling from Pennsylvania.
All right. Masa, yes. Calling from Pennsylvania. Welcome to life.
Yeah. I was asking, what is the discussion about? I mean, you explain like a lot of things, but you never really pinpoint any one thing that the discussion is about. So I didn't all understand. Right,
it's because you're just joining us. That is why the discussion here is based on peace. All right. What do you think, or what are the some of the important points that you have that yes, indeed, we need to, you know, be preaching to the people of Liberia that yes, indeed, the peace can be maintained in a country. All right.
Peace in which way, Peace in which way? Because as far as I'm concerned, Liberia is peaceful. Peace in which way? Oh, peace in the form
Liberia
of
is peaceful,
Mandingo,
but right now it's because
Mandingo
you are
versus other people.
All right. Liberia is peaceful because I know the reason that you are saying this, because we went through the 12 years peace and that we all enjoy it, you know, peacefully. That's why you are saying this. But right now, the rumors that is going around, you know
well,
that
we can't
Liberia
speak
is
based
gonna
on
take
rumors.
The invasion, right?
You don't know if that's true.
And no, it is true. You know, we don't come on social media to make anything like people just tell us we can make our riches and before we say anything, right?
So what
all
are
right.
you basing
so
on
now,
the bread and peaceful? What are you basing our own on?
All right. While I know that it's not peaceful in Liberia, we all believe that, to be honest, right? We have 16 tribes in Liberia. And
yes.
Those 15 tribes, you know, all goes against one tribe, which is the Mandingo tribe, because they are giving some negative voice to the Mandingo people that yes, indeed, that they are complaining about. They cannot be listening to those voice and entertain peace in the country. All right. So we are coming on social media here to talk to people to see how best those statements can be changed, how best people can think twice to avoid those kinds of stuff. So that we can, count
every and each Liberian individual in Liberia has one Liberian, right? So that's why we are talking about here. So
okay, now I understand the discussion now. So basically, you're just talking about, it's not about politics.
It's not about politics. I'm not here to tell people who to go vote for. I'm not here to tell people, because I know the choice of the majority choice is my choice, all right? If I'm really advocating for peace, all right? The majority choice is my choice, all right? But we know nothing can be done in Liberia without peace, because even yesterday when the CDC hold a press conference, you know, they were saying that this election is counted to be their election. So if all they know, they're expecting victory, all right? No matter how, they're expecting victory. So if and if the victory that they're expecting, if they are now announced like a winner, so what do you think is going to happen? So these are the stuff we are talking to people to show to them what the world peace means, all right? So that, yes, indeed, everybody can hold on to their peace, I mean, onto their anger to see how best we can intercede.
So it is political then. So we're talking politics now.
No, actually, I'm not talking politics.
But you know what, CDC is a Liberian political party.
So yeah, I'm just saying this in order to give you the detailed information, but I'm not talking politics. I'm not telling people vote CDC. I'm not telling people vote UP. CDC, UP, they are all my lover party, and I believe that anyone people of Liberia choose have been chosen by me. All right? So that is my point.
I just wanted to understand what was going on.
So what is your view about what I just told you that yes, indeed?
With the whole Mandingo, like even me, I'm Mandingo.
Yeah, Mandingo people feel that and they are complaining.
You know, my tribe is Mandingo. My mother and father both are Mandingo people. So I understand where the Mandingo people are coming from. And you know, but Mandingo people too, they gotta try to include themselves in things. If you don't include yourself in stuff, you will always be like the minority, because when you put all the Mandingo people together, they can be plenty more than the other tribes. But they don't mix with the other tribes like that. They keep more to themselves. Mandingo people like the Fula people of Liberia. They keep to themselves, they keep to their business, and they worry about their money business. So if you don't want to get involved in the politics of the country, if you don't want to become a mean person to better your people, even in America, when Spanish people in America want to get recognition, they can vote their people into the offices. But Mandingo people need to get to a certain level, they got to come together. That's the only way. They have to come together to try to make a change in what's going on, to make way so that their revenue can... Let me tell you, look at Jewish people in America. Jewish people own like almost the whole New York. They got the money. Mandingo people got money within themselves, their businesses, their thing. And Mandingo people got money. They need to show up for one another. That way, even the people.
So now you are trying to tell us that you are trying to respect you. So now you are trying to tell us that Mandingo people, like their wealth and their stuff is not for one another. So they don't actually, you know, like love one another. That's why they are not.
No, I'm not saying that. What I'm saying is they don't want to be involved in politics. Only very few Mandingo people can say, oh, I want to run for this office, or I want to. And some of the Mandingo people who can even reach to that level, when they reach there, they can forget that they're Mandingo.
All right, let me tell you something. Maybe you are not been following the whole political issue. Mandingo people, they do participate in
they don't participate. I'm saying few of them participate. Very few of them participate. And the place then they can run at, look at Lofa. Like, you got Mandingo people in the city. How many Mandingo people in the city of Monrovia? Really, in the city of Monrovia, holding a key position. Very few. You can count it all on your hand.
Exactly. That very I agree.
I'm not talking about. I'm not talking about the rural area. Then. I'm not talking about Lofa. Then. We moving from Lofa to come in the city to come go to school in the city. We come into Monrovia to come go to school in Monrovia. Then you talking about Lofa when you finish with your high school in Lofa, where you can come to go to university. Then I'm Monrovia, you can come to. We need people in Monrovia. You when you eat Lofa, they will not treat you bad. You eat Lofa, that's so yo. You will feel love that in a city you can feel the discrimination that in a city you can know to say oh they poor they not like Mandingo poor. So that in a city we supposed to have representation and we got big community there in the city of Monrovia. But
so
where the Mandingo poor
so, so why do you have to tell the people of Liberia to recognize in recognizing the Mandingo Mandingo tribe? As Liberia.
That one is a non-factor. Whether you want to recognize them as Liberian, you know, recognize they Liberian.
Yeah, they are Liberian, but
the 16 those people... tribes, they can't name the 16 tribes or add naming Mandingo people. Whether the Mandingo people then will come true for one another, so we can show face, so that. But when you see... Two, when one Mandingo person win over here, all the other Mandingo people win one ring, that simply. Why y'all can't spread out? When one Mandingo person run over here, that their own Mandingo brother will go and run against them to divide the vote.
Exactly, and that's the same problem we are.
Spread out.
And that's the same problem we are for now in district number two, because district number two seemed to be... the district that occupies the massive Mandingo people, in the whole Montserrado. So that one district that occupies the massive Mandingo people, due to our disunity, something goes wrong and somebody else was, elected to be a representative for that district.
Me.
Because
over
we
here,
had a 2, 3, 4, 5.
Over here, I'm looking for money.
I'll
go to Africa. I'm looking for money. But when I come to Liberia, I can see it, but I'm not a politician. I don't care for any of those kind of thing. But it's like I can just be looking at it like why y'all can't try to divide and conquer instead of. Everybody go sit down one place. How anything will happen? Then you will sit down and complain. Oh, this one not happening. This one not happening. This one not happening. But you're not putting full of effort to make it to happen. When you united, whether people won't recognize you, they not won't recognize you. You will be recognized.
You gotta be united. Exactly. You have to be united. That's the main point. And if this unity came about in our community and things go wrongly, so people couldn't listen to their leaders. Some people even come on social media.
It was Mandingo people used to really be united. Mandingo people used to really be united.
Before, right? Actually.
Yeah, but right now,
we don't know what is actually wrong. So these are the things we really want to know.
You know what's happening?
No.
The older people don't want to give younger people chance, and the younger people
don't want to listen to the older people.
Don't know how to listen.
I agree. That point, I think I'm going to write that point.
The older people just want to sit down there. Accountable for nothing. And
it's very, very interesting. That point is very, very interesting. The older people don't want to, listen to the younger people, and the younger people don't.
The younger people have the strength to do what the older people they say. Exactly. In a more modern way. So the younger people don't want to listen, and the older people don't want to give the young people a chance.
This is a serious problem.
Me, I gotta go. But
all right, thank you very much for being here. Thank you very much for being here. And that
I see my boy Rakim watching.
I'm sorry?
We have one American viewer.
Thank you very much for being here today. We really appreciate the view that you gave us. I think that, yes, indeed, people were listening to you, thousands of people listening to you right now. You make a very important point so that they can learn from what you have said, and they can also try to do something better for themselves in order to be united. All right. Thank you so much, and meet you next time. People try to call here, and if you are listening to me, don't call me direct call, because I'm not going to take any call direct call, because I'm on live with people are listening to the views and other stuff. Good afternoon, brother.
Yeah, good afternoon. My name is Musa Mjate.
All right, where are you calling from?
I'm calling for Philadelphia.
Oh, thank you for being here. Thank you for being part of this show. And I appreciate of you being here. And I believe that you're going to make a very important point, like what my sister just from saying, and so that our people can learn, you know, to do something better for the next, you know, future. All right?
Exactly.
What is your contribution?
It's so saddening and frustrating to see our brother out there who don't want to be together, and they want to be fighting here and there just for power.
I'm telling you, very, very sorry.
If you look at our labyrinth setting right now, we are the tribe who be marginalized when it comes to officiating government. All right. People don't, whatever we do for other tribes, they don't like us.
Exactly.
All right. We try to do whatever that is best in order for us to be one. But yet and still, sometimes they will tell you, yes, indeed, I'm going to vote for you. But at the end of the day, they're not going to do it. So while we, as a Manigo people, we can work together as a team, to work together as a brother, as a sister, as an uncle, and as a mother, so that we, at least, because the particular district 2 they are talking about is dominated by our people.
Exactly. The Maxi Mandingo community. Exactly.
It's dominated. It's so sad and shameful to see them losing that district.
It's disgracing. I swear to God.
All right? It's so sad. So, I mean, they need to govern themselves and then go back on the drawing board to see that what really happened, they lose that district. All right? They are happy already. There's nothing we can do about that. But we need to go back on the drawing board and sit down and see the older people and the young people as well. My sister just stated, we can go back and reconsolidate. We can still get by the district.
Yeah.
All right? We can still get by the district. But that would depend
on... I really like the comments that the sister just said, that, you know, the older people is very good to make decision, right? But at least in making decision, you can make decision, but the youth are the one that can work out your decision, all right? So you need to listen to them, all right?
Yeah.
So I'm...
Before other tribe in Liberia used to say, the Manigo people, they can now be move from behind each other. Other tribes used to admire us for that.
Exactly.
But none of this, those things are no more. Why are we leaving our value? Eh? Those things are no more. All right? We used to be sincere to each other. We open to each other. Even when it comes to job, we help each other with job. We used to do all of those things. All right? Some of us were there. We helping some of our brothers. It's just today... And God help us, we came on this side, we're trying to make life. And even with that, we're here, we still supporting them out there.
Exactly.
We don't want to see them there. It's just we don't have the hand now to help the district in order to facilitate some things, you know, that will help our people. Because that place is predominated by our people.
Yeah.
There's nothing you can say other than that.
No problem.
Absolutely. All right? There, no kind of thing happen. And up to, oh, yeah, that other person, because they now left. The other men who already there, already started some project, EMR some project. Why can't the other people give them the chance, benefit of the doubt? Let me end the term. We have it end the term
and,
at least.
And brother, in addition to what you have said, you know, some people, I mean, somebody just sent me a comment by saying that, you know, Madingo people, one problem we have here, our mouth is our problem. You see,
right.
People mouth can say everything. What they used to tell
right.
Brother Sekane, they say, oh, in fact, the man can, anytime he's coming from out of work or he's going to work, he can pull his witches up. He don't even speak to us.
Exactly.
Okay.
No, let me tell you, one of the problems we have, we're going to observe that our people don't respect leaders. They don't respect authority. And that's one of the key points there. You know, you don't have, the man is a representative. You don't have it to say every day, or go to everybody door to say, oh, hello, or I got to want to give it to you individually. No! Something that will benefit the masses, the community, that's what we're talking about. All right? That's why whatever other tribe or whatever live there, but something that will benefit everybody in general, that's what we're talking about. It don't have to be something for your pocket to go get an individual. That's not the kind of leadership we're talking about. We're talking about leadership that will benefit everybody. But some of them try to hold the man in that kind of personal that the man can, even the man can go to their houses and speak to them. I mean, it's terrible.
So, brother, what do you have to tell the people of Liberia in order to post up to those kinds of stuff? You know, this is a very
interesting. Let me, tell one before I can come with my recommendation. You see, for me, I served in the law enforcement for like 10 years in Liberia. And before I even left, before leaving my position, I served as Deputy Police Commander at Rabat International Airport.
Wow, congratulations, brother, for saving the life of Liberia.
That's about my good support, man. Other people there, even telling that I'm a Maningo personnel, they said no, because you don't behave like the way other people behave. I said, how? I said, no, other people, they save a lot than we do. We save a lot, too.
Exactly. And we...
Other people feel that we, when it comes to civilization, we also have civilization. That's not true.
Exactly.
Not true.
We have right for one month that we're talking
about every day. That's it. When I go our community, people respect me. They see me, oh, chief, what can we do for you? What here can we do for you? You know? But for my own people, when I go there, they respect me. They say, Prophet, I respect at home. Even so that when I go, some of them misbehave, my officer that I sound with me, they will want to take action on my behalf.
Wow.
On a serious note, they will want to take action on my behalf. I even get my back. But you know, I don't care how, when you care, you care.
Exactly.
There's no way you can extreme yourself from that. I'm a Maningo person, I don't care how. And that's not me make myself Maningo person. It's the will of God.
Exactly.
So I can't dispute that. So my recommendation to our people, they need to be together.
Exactly. Unity.
The unity our forefathers had in our country before, while they were helping others, we need to come back with that same thing so that we can forge our head.
All right.
All right?
Thank you.
Liberia belongs to all of us.
Exactly.
We all serve. All right, we serve. For me, I serve diligently. I can boast of that. And if you check the truck, it's there. Go to Central right now, it's there. Liberia National Police, when you say Musa Jate, you'll see everybody will say yes, indeed. He's a person, he was there for everybody.
Exactly.
I don't discriminate. But our people, they are kind of a people, they don't respect leadership.
Exactly. Can you imagine just few days ago? An individual comes on social media, insult the entire Muslim.
Exactly.
Imams.
Yeah. Let me specify my job. You can't do that.
You can't do
these
that.
These people, they are spiritual leaders. You don't go again. You don't go and just go out and there and just say.
This, you call yourself so-called journalist, and then you put this on social media.
You don't do that.
You stay behind to apologize.
You don't do that. That is a disgrace.
It's a disgrace to the community. You don't do that.
It's a disgrace.
But I consider that to be illiterate, you know?
That's what I would say. Even they try to involve politics in the mouth, that doesn't mean that you go on the social media and just start to voice those things.
Stop them. Call their names in person. Call their location.
It's bad.
Wow. Yeah. It was very,
so,
very
rude. So, first to our people, they need to respect their leaders.
All right.
All right.
So, you said
unity. That's why all a warlord behavior. They will now move on behind Prince Johnson.
Exactly.
That's where people should be.
I respect
they
you.
They now move on behind Prince Johnson. What Prince Johnson says, that's it. All right?
Yep.
We really need to think twice to see how best we can come back without seeing unity our foreparents had in our country before. We need to do that.
I have a brother here, Adam Sangare. He said he's extending his greeting to you. That yes, indeed,
okay.
Your topic is very, very interesting, and nothing you are saying but the truth. Our people just need to, you know, reflect on what we were doing before, and we still need to bring the old system, because the new system,
exactly.
Running mob system that we are bringing now, is not going to
help.
All right, because we are Madingo people, we are the one that can say everything. Yeah. In fact, somebody even told me that Madingo people, they cannot go against you until you become somebody. I don't know how true is that.
What kind of hatred is that? What kind of hatred is that? Eh? What kind of hatred is that? We need to stop. We need to stop, man. That is so, it's so sad, man. It's painful. We need to
very,
stop.
Very, very painful.
So thank you, brother.
People
so
that even
live
in this history, they don't even take it to be like a beast stuff. It's not even... because they were divided. Some party vote for Mr. XYZ, some party vote for Mr. XYZ, so they don't care.
They don't care. This is a clear manifestation that they're not together. That alone.
All right. The main point that you gave us here, we really admire that you say unity and respect need to be
respected. And bring back those value our foreparents had before, so that we can once again be together as brother and sister and mother in the community. All right.
Thank you very
thank
much.
You so
for
much
those
for
two
you.
Important points, the unity and respect need to be restored. Thank you very much, brother. I really appreciate those 2 points. All right. Those are the kinds of people that we need to call on this show to give us idea. All right. One brother was just calling, but somebody was online. I didn't add him. So you can call back so that you can touch the green button back so that you can be live and express your point. All right. So people, I hear the wish to listen to you. All right. People want to get your view. All right. The brother is here. Bye. All right. Thank you, brother, for adding. All right. So now, the brother will soon be coming on, and you're going to...
Hey, what's...
All right. Good afternoon, brother. Your name and where you are calling from today?
Hello.
Yeah, good afternoon. You are live. Your name, where you calling from?
Yeah. My name is Che, and I'm calling from the U.S., Indianapolis, Indiana.
All right, Indiana. Welcome to the show, brother.
Yeah.
All right. So, what is your view, brother?
Yeah, for me, I'm a Christian, but I always love to follow the Muslim religion because the Muslim people, they serve as some religion who show peace and unity. So this time around, to see things going apart, that even for me is not show any together there for me, because even the senior brother who just leave the land, he was a Davide Kumaro at the place I lived before. He know me too good.
Yes.
And if you see him, you see somebody who got a passion, and you see somebody who you can see and know the love that he showed to everyone.
Exactly.
That big brother back there, at the time he was deputy commander, If you carry complaint to the station, why are you Muslim? Why are you Christian? Why are you who? He will put it right where it belongs, and he will make sure he will calm things down. What are you right saying about election of peace? I know. Yeah. And for me, I live, not that I live a fuller woman, but I have a fuller woman in smell of things where I live before. I usually use a cell phone in a shop. I'm the first person to see fuller woman trust to even go behind the counter.
Wow.
Because, you know, the way you live with them, the way you treat yourself, they open up to you.
Exactly.
And because of that, I really learn from the Muslim that I want eating with big person. Even if I fail, and my older are done, okay, yeah, I can't leave that pen until they get you. That shows some respect. That shows some respect. So, you know, let's be frank. I'm not a Muslim, but I really admire the Muslim. They together. You see Muslim men go, you see with a Christian go somewhere, oh, they don't get Pentecostal churches, so I can't go there. Oh, they don't get Catholic churches, I can't go there. Muslim men go anywhere you see Muslim pray there.
Exactly.
Yeah, he prayed that. I always admire him for that. So my brother, I really pray that they come back together. Because I really do love
Muslim. We're gonna say amen to your prayer, and the problem here that we are facing today, actually, the Mandingos, the Liberians Mandingos, are the one that brings disunity among them because of political reason. All right, it's just because of political reason that this unity came about. But actually, we are trying to see how best we can restore. We can restore the love. We can restore the unity. We can restore the peace that was among us before. And you know that people used to recognize us as a Mandingo. All right, so we are not. We don't want to be a Mandingo of today. We want to be a Mandingo of tomorrow as well. All right. So I really appreciate your point. So what are your messages to the Mandingo people that yes, indeed, some of those things that they need to do again, you know, to maintain the unity and the peace and those kinds of respect that you were saying that if you are eating with your order, you know, you need to hold the pens until they finish eating. So all those stuff. So what kinds of advice that you have, yes, indeed, you can pass over to the people in our communities? Are you there?
Yeah.
So what is your message to the Mandingo community and to the Liberian people to recognize them good, to recognize them well? You know, what is your message to the Mandingo people for the unity, and what is your view to the people of Liberia by recognizing them, you know, to stop those kinds of wars, abuses, and other stuff?
Yeah. What I got to say to them is like, we have to come together as one, because they said together we stand and united we fall.
Exactly.
So, you know, to get rid of one person is easier than to get rid of a whole family.
Mm-hmm.
So it's good to be together, because when you're together, even if the person don't get it, it can't even show that the other person don't get it. You understand? It's good to be there for one another. So if any other thing really breaking it apart, you know, part of the time when the time reach, even the people we're going to sacrifice ourselves for, and, you know, say some bad thing for other people against them, you know, because we want to get the power. When you get the power today, we still going to see one another tomorrow that we don't want to talk good about. We're going to live with you. You're going to live with us. We're all going to be in the same society. So it's good to put it right where it belongs. When the politics come, you make sure how to go on and say things about people. You know what to say. You know what to say, and your brother can still stay with you no matter which party you're from, no matter which background you're from. But you don't do things that will make people look at you ugly tomorrow after election or after, you know, maybe the thing you seeking to get, and then after that, and then you won't try to come around. And you know, we the human, we can say, yeah, we forgive, but sometimes other people got it in mind that when they see tomorrow, that thing can still play on them, because you don't know, we are human beings, we're different.
Exactly.
Yeah. So let our keep together.
What work for you may not work for me. Exactly.
Because, you see, they got a lot of people who all up here, my brother, even the Spanish. The Spanish people here, they care for one another.
Exactly.
Even here in a house, you can see four bedroom apartment here. You see four family inside Spanish, because why they hold together. You understand? But we can't do it.
He checks on Manigo here. He checks on Christian here. He checks on Liberians, Guinea. The moment they bought two family in the house, even brother and sister said the plower.
Exactly.
Because why? Everybody want to be on it. We know everybody need the freedom, but everything come as time. So I want to urge you, I thank you for the show and our monitoring. And just keep the courage and make sure talk to our people. Let them be able to come over their view. Let them be able to come out to see what taking their apart so they can be able to reunite. And so we can be able to move left forward because left is ahead or it's not behind us.
Thank you very much, brother. I really appreciate your views and the audience were listening to you. And I believe that they're all going to accept the fact that you just mentioned. Really, we appreciate your effort. That was a Christian man calling from United States of America here, advising the Mandingo people to come together, to be united. That yes, indeed, before the Mandingo of yesterday and today's Mandingo are quite different. You know, because the love that we have for one another before, the respect that we have for one another before, and, you know, we need to restore those respect, all right? The brother, you know, as you're watching and you listen to the brother, actually, he make a very interesting and beautiful points to you and myself so that we can learn from him, all right? Somebody trying to call here. All right, ladies and gentlemen, if you want to call, you can touch the green button at the bottom side of the right, so that you can be part of the show. So whenever you touch that green button, and then I'm gonna add you, and you can share your idea to the people of Liberia, to be Pesek and Mandingo people as well, because right now we don't want anything like disunity among us. We don't want anything like conflict among us because of political reason. All right, this political issue is just a period of time. It's going to leave us, and we should stay be like the way we are, all right? So the only thing we are talking here is peace. All right, Luseni Asata Abukaba is bike. So, brother, if you are bike with your comments, and you can toss the green button so that I can add you here, and you give us the three main reasons or the three main important stuff that you have to give to your people in order to bring the unity that we are seeking for. All right. You know, sometimes we actually is to our greater surprise. Our greater surprise, I say, well, our greater surprise, that this thing happens, all right? It's so painful to us, that this thing happens, actually. And never, ever again, we want to see things like this, all right? One thing I want to say here, I want for you guys to stop of saying that it was the fault of others, all right? You make an error, I make an error, and if there is no one to rectify the error that somebody make, and then, so are you telling me we are gonna be like that forever? I don't think this is the thing that, yes, indeed, we can do, right? So I think that we need to work hard, all right? We are doing these videos, it's not like we like to show our face or we like to, you know, be talking every day. It's like we want to see our people united. We want to see our people together. We want to see our people with one voice, all right? And the only way this stuff can be done, like the comments that people are giving now, you know, the older people need to give chance to the younger people, you know, because they are the enforcer of any decision that they are taking. Brother said that the unity should be the unity and respect that we had before. We should make sure to restore those unity and respect because things are changing. As you know, Mandingo people, we like to talk something, you know,
Because if you tell your son that, oh, okay, this is your leader, but he's so proud. In fact, he used to speak to me. He's like this, he's like that. Do you think that time for election, that person is going to vote for that candidate of your choice? I don't think so, because of the bad, names that you've been giving. He may think that that person is a bad person. All right. We need to stop saying some things, because the entire, world say that Liberian people, more especially the youth, they are very easy to convince. All right. They believe just a few words. You tell them few words and give them small thing, they are totally convinced. All right. I don't think this is the way through. I don't think this is the way through of your development of your one nation, indivisible, with liberty and justice for every one of us. All right. I don't think this is the way. All right. I don't think this is the way. All right. Brother, again, I don't think this is the way. All right. So we need to put things together. We need to do things together. We need to advise one another. All right. This is why we are here every day, to advise people, so that yes, indeed, things can be okay in that place. All right. I'm going to try to connect somebody who really have an interesting point to make today. All right. So that he can express himself as well, because one person cannot say everything. All right. That is why we are inviting people and make sure that.
All right.
What
are you doing, Alan?
Good afternoon, sir. Hello. Are you there?
Yeah, I'm here.
All right, your name and where you are you calling from? He has a very, I think the connection did not work out for him. And can you imagine everywhere around the world, people singing for their one peace, one love, Liberian? You got to think twice. This is the best time that you can think twice. All right? Oh, you need to call back. I don't know what happened. Your line dropped. I don't know why. Your line dropped. All right. Let me try to add you again if it's possible. All right. All this is to tell you that yes, indeed, not only Liberians need peace, but the entire world need peace in Liberia, because they know what I've been, what I've passed in the past. All right. They can remember, what you guys went through. All right. This is why everybody around the world need you to see peace. All right. So if you can destroy your own trap, I don't know what to say, all right? You're gonna see the other people united, all right? You spoil your home, then you see the other people, good. People of Liberia, together as one. People of Liberia, come together as one. We know you guys have different standard, but together. You enjoy that music. I hope that you enjoy that music, because it's a song of progress. It's a song of and, you know, peace advocating. He's a son of love. He's a son to restore the unity among us, all right? So, segregation is not taking us nowhere, all right? It's going to stay us to where we are, all right? So, and we don't want that. We don't want that, okay? We just want to see ourselves forward, all right? So, that thing that we were doing, you know, let's put stop to that, all right? Let's try to do something new, all right? Let's try to do something new that will be able to, you know, to help us and help the next generation, all right?